that came to me when I knew that I was free. When my Savior found me, put his arms around me. Oh, the joy that set me free. Hallelujah, Jesus. Oh, the joy that set me free. Praise God. And we're talking about refreshment, refreshing on tonight and reformation. Amen. My name is Denise. Elder Denise Brown, and I'm coming from Tabernacle of Praise, where our bishop is, Bishop Alfred Jackson. Amen. And we thank him for this opportunity, amen, that we can come forth and show you the joy of Jesus. Amen. That's what revival is all about, revival. If I need to be refreshed, it means that I'm missing out on something. Amen. It means that something has ceased. Amen. Amen. But the joy that Jesus gave unto us, amen, will never cease. Amen. Because he is eternal. And everything that God did for us is eternal. So I came to remind you today to shake yourself. Amen. Because there is a shaking going on in the land. So shake yourself. Let fear go. Hallelujah, Jesus. Let worry leave you and anxiety leave you. Because the joy that came unto you is an eternal thing. Praise God. God said that the joy that he gave us, Elder, the world can't take it away. This situations can't take it away. Hallelujah. We're standing on a firm foundation. Glory to God. There is a shaking, amen. And the only thing that's going to stand is the kingdom of God. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, God. I love the Lord because I get notes, amen, and he just moved me from that. Hallelujah. But I thank God today for the joy that he gave unto us, y'all.
Amen.
Oh, glory to God. Father, I come before you praising you and giving you glory, God. Hallelujah, Jesus. You are our answer, Lord God. Yes. You are the way, Father. So, God, we praise you today as these words go forth, Lord God. They're not coming from Denise, Lord God, but they're coming straight from heaven, Lord God, because we are your vessels, Lord God. Each and every night, God, that someone stand, Lord God, and declare your word. We're your vessels. We're your instruments, Lord God. So let your will be done. And as it go through the ear, God, we decree right now, Father, that it will reach households, Lord God, that people are waiting for an answer, God. And the answer will appear, Father, as your word comes forth, Lord God. And we decree that the scales are falling from their eyes, Lord God, and that their ears are unstopped, Father, that they can hear deliverance, Lord God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
God is a good God, y'all.
Yes.
Hallelujah, Jesus. You might find it strange, but the title that I have, the Word of God, is our reference. And that's what's been going on in this revival. The reference of God, meaning that the alignment has taken place in the Word of God. So each elder or minister that come forth, amen, there's an alignment that's going on. That God is giving his word so we can, the reference of his word, it says, the day you hear my voice, harden not your heart. Ah, God, faith comes by hearing and hearing the word of God. Faith comes when we read the word and let the word us on how we should be living and what we should be doing and how we're going to mimic and follow the perfect man. The word is referencing us, y'all. So, and then it says, and faith comes by hearing, and hearing, he's still speaking, y'all.
Amen.
He's still speaking.
Amen.
Bishop was preaching about the church and the kingdom. The kingdom hears his voice.
Yeah.
He's still speaking, y'all.
Right,
he's still leading us. Yeah. He said he'll never leave us, nor will he ever forsake us.
Yeah.
So he's still speaking. Come on, there's times where we read the Bible and it's our reference. And we take people out of the Bible, which he put there for us to see what he's able to do through me and men.
Amen.
But we begin to start making gods, other gods. We begin to start building more denominations.
Go ahead, man.
Come on, y'all. We begin to say, I want to dance like David. David had a reason to dance. David had a story to tell. God, David went through something and God showed himself strong.
Yeah.
What's your story?
Oh.
said, in his likeness.
Go ahead.
And in the garden, when they sinned, Jesus already had the plan. He already told them what he was going to do.
All right.
So now, and Jesus created this world so that he can fellowship with us in this world.
All right.
Come on, nothing separates us from Jesus, because it was his love that caused Christ to come to bring us back into alignment. Mm. And the word tells us that nothing can separate us from his love. Right. So as the word go forth from one preacher to the next, that is living water that is flowing.
All right.
And the
All right.
living water of God flows through eternity, y'all. Mm. Hallelujah. There's no trouble. There's no virus. There's no leader. Amen. That can stop the will of God. And then like it was preached already, we see things going on that is ill. It's just not justice.
Mm.
It's just not righteousness.
Mm.
But wait on God.
Wait on God. Amen.
Wait on God, y'all. There's a reckoning day coming.
Yeah.
Somebody preached about a reckoning ball, said that now since our president is in the office, and I have nothing against anybody because I'm a kingdom person.
Amen.
Whether you like me or not, I love you.
Amen.
Because
Amen.
The greater one lies in me.
That's
His
right.
water is flowing through me. Amen. Amen. You might hurt my feelings, but I still got to love you.
That's right.
So they said now the reckoning ball is in the White House.
Mm.
So I said the kingdom controls
That's
the
right.
earth. Come on, so which way will that reckoning ball swing?
Yeah.
It depends on us, the way the ball gonna swing.
Yeah.
But it depends on the kingdom.
The kingdom.
What's gonna happen in the earth?
Come on,
y'all.
Yeah.
He left us here for a reason.
Right.
He could have saved us and took us home.
Yeah.
But he saved us and he left us here. Because there's a purpose
yeah.
in every one of us, y'all.
Yeah.
Come on, refreshing. I have scriptures here about in Isaiah where it says, whose report will you believe?
Uh-huh.
Come on, it's going to show if you believe the report of the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Because you're going to stand and then stand.
Uh-huh.
And you're going to walk a righteous walk and you're going to talk a righteous talk.
Mm-hmm.
Because it is a kingdom. It is a body of people.
Yeah.
And God said that the earth is groaning, y'all.
Mm.
There's so much going on. You can stand in the supermarket and you can hear the groans. Are you willing to turn around and say, ma'am, thus and so? Because we got to answer the groan.
Yeah.
We got to answer the groan.
Yeah.
He left us here to answer the groan.
Yeah.
Glory to God. I was like confused. God, what is it you want me to say? What is this refreshing thing? Hallelujah. The word tells me if we repent, go to God and repent, and then we can begin to be refreshed. Amen. Because nothing that God did has stopped.
Yeah.
That's right.
Nothing
Amen.
That God did has ceased.
Yeah.
Everything we need him to do has already been done.
All right.
So if you don't see victory in your life, stop and acknowledge God.
Mm-hmm.
Get to the reference
mm.
and see where you are in it.
Mm-hmm.
Repent and go on. He told the woman at the well that the water that you drink, come on, y'all.
Yeah.
She can always have it.
Yeah.
She can always have it.
Mm.
Because that well is on the inside of us.
Yeah. Yeah.
So
yeah.
if that well is not springing up, something's wrong. You, the elder told us,
right.
amen, to go back.
Yeah.
And reevaluate this.
Yeah.
Because this is an eternal well, y'all.
Yeah.
It's an everlasting well.
Yeah.
It takes us from everlasting to everlasting.
Yeah.
So there is no situation. And let me tell y'all something. They read it all. I mean, through the week, you will hear the different situations that they're bringing to us in our reference.
Mm-hmm.
And how God delivered.
Mm.
And how God set us free.
Yeah.
How he caused us to use wisdom. Amen?
Amen.
To be wise. Amen. Hallelujah. To stand and know that God is going to make a way. Praise God. Amen. So that's why I'm coming here today to tell you that your refreshing is on the inside.
Amen.
So I was telling somebody, we use the phrase, my sister in Christ.
Mm-hmm.
Or my brother in Christ. And it was an African man that said, why do you say that?
Mm.
And he had to remind me that God came for the world.
All right.
Mm.
And when he looks on us, he sees the blood of Christ. Not just us that came to the altar.
All right.
But he sees yes. the remission of sin. But it's up to us that know, that's been washed, that's confessing his name, to let your brother know that God loves you.
Uh-huh.
He came for you.
Mm-hmm.
The gun bangers, the homosexuals,
uh-huh.
It's not the Republican nor the Democrat that's going to deliver these
people.
That's right.
They have no deliverance in them, because both of them, the scales are unbalanced, y'all.
Yeah.
Come on,
yeah.
It's God.
Yeah.
And God alone.
That's right.
We're talking about revival.
Yeah.
And reformation. The church need to turn things.
Yeah.
The church need to get intact with God. They need to read that word. And they need to read it over and over until they see the world in this picture.
Mm.
Until they see the people of God in the picture. When I start studying and I say, God, we never start this thing off right.
Mm-hmm.
They said they came over here for liberty to serve God in peace, right? But it never started that way.
It never started that way.
No.
It
oh my God.
Come on, y'all.
We need to reform,
y'all.
Yes. Yes.
If I have to deny my brother, I'm gonna deny my brother, because it is the Christ that raised me and gave me this joy. And when we stand on the word of God and do what he told us, my brother is coming behind me.
All right.
Come on, he will honor his word.
Amen.
When we stand and do what the word declares us to do.
Mm.
Come on, y'all. Paul said it kind of dumb.
All right.
Yeah.
Come on, I love the wisdom that's in this house. And never think I don't. I'm learning and I'm gleaning.
Mm.
I love the wisdom. But I'm talking to somebody out there that didn't have the teaching that I didn't get.
Mm.
The Holy Ghost will do it all.
Mm.
He said, you need no man, hallelujah, to teach you. But I will teach you all things.
Yes.
So we have no excuse, y'all.
Yes, sir.
And just like Paul, with all the knowledge, we still got to count that as dumb. Because what they got to hear is the spirit of the living God.
Yes.
Yeah.
What they have to hear is the one that will refresh us.
Yes.
Glory to God. And basically, that's all I have to say. It's refreshing and comes through the Spirit of God.
Yeah.
And I wanna encourage you all to relax.
Mm-hmm.
Sit down.
Mm.
Be still.
Yeah.
And know that God is God.
Yeah.
If he kept the Israelites in Goshen, he will keep us.
Mm.
I hear about the reports of the virus coming in the building, but this building is not the kingdom, y'all.
Yeah.
I am in the kingdom, and I'm fretting not. Whom shall I be afraid?
Mm.
Hallelujah, Jesus. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Come on, y'all.
Yeah.
Come on, his shadow is covering me.
Yeah.
All right. Glory to God, these things shall not come down thee.
Yeah.
You got to walk this thing. You got to believe this thing. Because what's going to cause them to run is us.
Mm.
When we allow God to work the work out of us. Hallelujah. Let that treasure out, y'all.
Mm.
Stop mixing up this natural body and let the treasure out.
Yeah.
Come on, let the glory come out. Glory to God.
Yeah.
You'll be refreshed.
Yes.
The lady at the well dropped her pot.
Yes.
She dropped her pot.
Go ahead now.
And she ran.
Yes.
She dropped the very instrument that would cause her to be able to get substance that she needs.
All right.
Everything you think that's been bringing you through. If it's not the Spirit of God, drop it. Drop it. Drop it. Drop it. Hallelujah, Jesus. It's like it was said, anything that's happening is happening because God allowed it.
Yes.
When he took the Israelites through the desert, he said, I want to know your heart.
Mm.
Oh, go ahead.
Come on, trouble comes. Trouble comes and persecution comes. Hallelujah. So that God would judge, know our hearts. What do you truly believe? Hallelujah, Jesus. Whose report do you believe? Hallelujah. If he take me home now, I'm still blessed, y'all.
Yeah.
Glory to God. We marvel over the Evans family, and I love Tony Evans and his family.
Mm-hmm.
But we marvel over how Jonathan stood and preached his mother's eulogy.
Mm-hmm.
And what he was saying, do we do it on this side or that side, we're still victorious.
Yeah, that's
so
right.
Don't let fear guide you.
Yes.
Don't let fear rule you.
Yeah.
Let the peace of God that surpasses all understanding rule and reign in you. Because the very thing that says, uh-uh, don't do that, the Spirit will say, it's okay. Mm. Go forth. He's telling us right now to go into the deep, y'all.
Go ahead.
That's why the buildings are down, y'all.
Yeah.
Go into the deep. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Yes.
It's revival time.
Yeah.
I believe that this word is going in the airway. Amen. From every person that speaks. And God is going to do a new thing. God is going to create something in the minds of his people that caused them to shake themselves and to rise. And it's going to begin in the households, Bishop.
Yes.
Families are coming together.
Yeah.
In my bedroom this morning, a young lady called and she was talking about that she's never been submissive to her husband. And while she was talking, God was talking to me. He said, you all are waiting to get to heaven, but the kingdom has come. He told me the story about when the man dies and his brothers have to take over and take care of the wife. And then several brothers come along and they take care. And then they get to heaven. They want to know whose wife is she going to be. That ain't heaven. We are one. We are one in the spirit, y'all. We are chasing after things that don't belong in our area.
Yeah.
Don't belong in our concept. Because the kingdom has come.
Yes.
We are in the kingdom.
Yes.
And that's how we got to see everything.
Yes.
You're looking for peace in heaven? We got peace right now. Hallelujah, Jesus. We're in the kingdom right now. It's just like Abraham when God called Abraham out, Pastor. He wasn't just calling him away from his father, but he was calling him to be transformed.
Right.
He was calling him, hallelujah, to start seeing things different. Glory. And he called him out of a pagan nation.
Yes, he did.
We can say that we think we're right special, but we came out of something. We came out of something. And what's going to make a difference when we come out of that something that our minds begin to change?
All right.
Because I can put on a fine suit and I can get my Bible and carry it, but if my mind is not changing, if I'm not releasing everything to the power of God, I'm just like the next one that's waiting to come in. Glory. I'm like the one, hallelujah, where God is knocking at the door. Come on, y'all. We declare today, amen, that the doors of these buildings will be wide open. Glory to God. And Jesus will be in the center of everything that we do.
Yes.
And it's not for fear that we are yielding ourselves to God. It's because of the love. It's because of love, y'all. He loved us.
Amen.
He's showing us how to love.
Yes.
He's showing us how to live in his kingdom and how to receive the things that he's already ordained.
Yes.
He's already ordained everything, y'all. Tell me if I'm going over. He's ordained everything. He said he has a plan for us. We love that scripture. But Jeremiah was in bondage. When he quoted that scripture, we're waiting to get out of bondage. You better rise up and declare that your Lord lives, and that your Lord saves, and that your Lord is able. Glory to God. And that's all I have to tell you today. Drink from the well that never runs dry.
Oh, yeah.
Drink from the well that never runs dry. That's the altar call right now, that you drink. Take a drink from the well that never runs dry.
Hallelujah.
It is an everlasting well. It is, and with the joy that he gave us that the world can't take away, we draw. We draw. And just like he created this world and put everything in the world that man needed. My brother said it earlier. God has a plan. He has a story for us.
All right.
And the reference that we have in the Bible about Elijah and all the rest of them, that's their story, y'all.
Yeah.
It lets us to know that God is able.
Yes.
So we waiting to hear. You want to hear Denise's story, and I want to hear Bishop's story, because we all got a story. But when we relax in God, He began to work that story out of us. But we got a spirit of mimicking. We want to mimic. Then He gave us this for a reference, y'all.
Yes.
He didn't tell us to mimic the thing. He didn't tell us to try to make yourself a Esther.
That's
he
right.
wants you to be Denise.
That's right.
He want to use the girl from Brooklyn.
Yeah.
Come on. He want to use the girl that ran the streets. He want to use the girl that could have went and got somebody to take care of another person. He want to use that story that God is able, y'all.
Yeah.
He's able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we can ask or think. And when you think about the fire that the Hebrew boys were in, and they didn't smell a fire. If you're scared to come to God today because of what you've done, God washes us clean.
Yes.
He washes us clean. And the only way they'll know it is by the power of your testimony.
Hallelujah.
Come on.
Hallelujah.
Let the blood wash you today. And let that living water spring up in your heart today. Let it spring up and begin to wash away everything that you've been leaning on.
All right.
Because all you need now is the Christ.
Amen.
That's why He's dwelling in us, y'all.
Yes.
So you got a story to tell. And how you begin to tell that story is to surrender your life to God.
Amen.
So we're calling on you today, wherever you are.
Yes.
Wherever you are, you can get in contact with the church, but right now it's just me, you, and Jesus.
Amen.
I'm talking to you that know you need God. I'm talking to you that there's havoc all in your house. I'm talking to you where your kids are somewhere you don't know where they are. I'm talking to you that lost a job 7 months ago and you don't know which way to turn. I'm talking to you that's waiting for that stimulus check. Come on. Let God arise in your life.
Yeah.
And every enemy be scattered. Everything that you've been so concerned about, those things scatter, y'all. They scatter.
They scatter.
So this is coming from Tabernacle of Praise in York County. Amen.
Amen.
And it's coming with the heart of God. Every person that stand in this pulpit is coming with the heart of God. Our pastor told us at the beginning of the year that there's a shift coming. And the shift has come. You know, because every time we hear a word, we get in the natural realm. And we start thinking about, well, God's going to shift me in this, and I'm going to get this. And no, He's shifting us in alignment.
Yes. All right,
He's shifting us in alignment.
All right. Yes.
And when we align ourselves, I think it's been said already this week, that's when the great impact is going to come.
All right.
Because that's what we're here for. Jesus came. And He opened up the eyes of many. The 12 got hold of what He said and they turned the world upside down.
Yeah.
We're in a world that we're not lacking anything. Anything we want to be known, we can send it out. On the phone, on the TV, on your tablet, we can send it out. So I decree today that there is a mighty turning. And when the word says that all things work together for the good of those who love the Lord,
yeah.
You got to really love them, y'all.
That's yes. right. That's right.
Love is what works. It's love that caused God to send Jesus to the earth. It was love that caused Jesus to endure the cross. And love lifted us, y'all.
Yes.
So don't grab His scriptures and think you can walk any kind of way you want to walk.
No.
But all things work together for the good of those who love God.
Yeah.
Because love is a powerful thing. It's a powerful thing. So when and the only way we can love Him is we take Him in. If we receive what He's done for us. So that's my altar call today. If you yield today and cry out to Jesus, but get in touch with the church and let us know. And we will help you any kind of way we can. We will read with you. We will give you scriptures. We'll pick you up if we have to. That's love. If it has to take us out of our way, we're gonna exhibit love to you. Because that's what the world needs today.
Amen.
And as things continue to go the way they are, wait on God. Things are changing.
All right.
That's right.
God is going to do a new thing.
Yeah.
Yeah. Amen. God is the one that delivered us.
Mm.
And he's able to keep us, y'all.
Yes.
Amen.
He is able to keep us, y'all.
Amen.
So no matter how rough it get, the joy of the Lord is our strength. The joy of the Lord is our strength.
Yeah.
Thank you for allowing me to share with you today. Amen. And as I go in prayer, I pray that you're going in prayer with me. Mm-hmm. Praise God. I pray that you're starting a relationship with God right now. Don't let the Christians cause you to jump through the loops you don't have to jump through, because God has did everything that you need. If you receive Christ in that living room, you're saved.
That's right.
You're saved. And start going, find you a Bible teaching, believing church, and start building up that relationship. We don't have to jump through loops anymore. The blood of Jesus has set us free. Glory to God. Father, we come before you praising you and giving you glory. We thank you for this opportunity, Lord God. You said that we were joiners with you, Lord. Co-laborers, Lord God. So what we do for you, Lord God, that we align in your will, Lord God. That we will truly be ministers of reconciliation, Lord God. So today we thank you for every soul that's coming unto you, Lord God. For that young man, Lord God, that don't know which way to go, we thank you for him, Lord God. For that mother that's suffering, Lord God, to feed her children, we thank you for her, God. We thank you, Lord, because you're able, God. You're able to cover the earth, Lord God. So as we here in York is lifting up your name, we decree that all over the world, on every continent, Lord, your people are rising up, Lord God. And we thank you for true revival. We thank you, Lord, that the refreshing has come. In Jesus' name we pray.
Yes.
And we give you thanks. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.